Hello, good people. It's your girl, Gracia, and welcome to the show. This is The Reality. And today we'll be talking about maintaining the balance between fashion and decency. Now, question, is it possible to be fashionable and decent? The answer to this question will be given to you shortly after the break. Don't go nowhere. We'll be right back. Welcome back. We live in a world which has normalized indecency. According to the norms of the world, decency is in the heart and in the body. But we know as Christians, we need to show our decency outwardly. And today we are going to talk about these things with a very special guest today with me. I have Lucy K Makeovers, CEO of Lucy K Makeovers. Welcome.
Thank you.
I'm so happy to have you. And also I have with me Sama Miguel.
Oh.
Welcome.
Thank you. It's a pleasure.
I'm so happy to have you. You guys look so great. I love your makeup. You look really beautiful.
Thank you.
You really express the Lucy K Makeovers.
Thank you so much.
And Sama Miguel, he's the CEO of SM Class. He really represents his brand.
Yeah, thank you.
You look so sharp. So tell me, what's the secret behind this sharpness?
Color blend, design, styling, and, you know, body fitness.
So all of this like that. So what if me, I don't have body fitness? I will not look sharp too, like.
No, not that you not look sharp. If you obviously look sharp, you should know your body. You understand?
Okay, so your body can define the kind of clothes you put on. That's you must it. Know your body.
Know your understand? Body. Especially your designer. Your designer really needs to know your body. You understand?
Okay.
When your designer needs your when he knows your body and your color.
Mm-hmm.
Color matters a lot. So your color now your outfit will blend it. Following your skin tone and your fitness and everything.
Okay. Yeah. By the way, you see how beautiful I look? This is what makeup can do to you. Please, cheer me up. Please. I look so nice. I look so beautiful. And as you can see, Lucy K, she looks so beautiful as well. That's what makeup can do for you. You see what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
See what I'm talking about? Okay, so can you tell me a little bit about your story, how it all started, and the ups and downs about it?
Okay, thank you so much for this opportunity. So it all started like a joke, as though I was playing. That back then in school, it was so difficult for me. And I noticed that I have this love for beauty.
Okay.
And when I see people with makeup, especially ladies, I so admire them. I just want to talk to them. I just want to be their friend, you know. So from there, I grew this interest to be a makeup artist.
Okay.
Yes, I started with no capital. Like, it's not as if there's a bag of money somewhere. Mm-hmm. You started with no. So I went to make inquiries, and from there, I registered.
Okay.
I started learning. We just had payment. So we know makeup item.
Okay.
So I was learning with my boss stuff. Later then, I had to buy my own stuff. Just struggling, you know. I buy powder today. The next day, I'm going in for mascara. The next day, I'm going in for lipstick.
It was really tough.
It was really tough.
Okay.
Because if you see me on the road and like, take this 1,000 and go and eat. No, I'm looking for the next makeup store.
Okay.
To get either eyeshadow or lipstick. So that was just it.
So it means it was a nice journey.
It was actually a nice journey, but it was really tough.
Yeah, but it was a nice journey. Can you tell us a little bit about just your designer story? What went on? What were the ups and downs about it? How was it?
Actually, it's a journey, but it all started in secondary school, you know. Really stop, like when I see a particular fabric, I try to get it with the color on it and see how I can attach other materials to it. And you know, it just started as a color blending, like I was very good at it. Something which is, like, just say, I can see it's inborn, you understand?
Yes, yes.
So I actually grew up with that. And each time, like, you know, as children, when you're preparing for Christmas, your mom is always like, no, let me get you a jean and a t-shirt. I'm always like, no, I don't want that stuff. So I prepared to go to the market with her. I point out the particular fabric. I want this fabric blended with this color.
Yes.
You understand? And she was like, You understand?
It started.
It started like that. And from there, now in school, people really gave me the name designer because I always see my stuff. Maybe for out in the school competitions, in modeling stuff. So they were always like show up. They're always like, ha, we gave you this mindset, we gave you this idea. So you get it. So, it
always
started.
Looking sharp.
Always sharp. Always
from
sharp.
A very tender age.
Yeah, from a very tender age. You ask, maybe if you're used with people from Progressive, ask them, they'll tell you about Summer Miguel.
Have you heard about Summer Miguel? Those from Progressive. Have you heard about Summer Miguel?
Yeah, they should know.
They should. You should. Okay, so. It means it was a very beautiful journey.
Yeah.
The color blend, knowing how to blend the colors, mastering your body shape, and also for makeup, the wanting to look beautiful all the time, because we know looking good is good business.
Yes.
Looking good is good business, isn't it?
Backload of money.
For sure.
Okay, so in as much as this were your passion, it was your passion, we've found ways to make money out of it. We found ways to make it a business. And I guess that's what we all are here.
No, definitely.
We all are doing here. Like you say, you have a makeup house, Lucy K, a beauty place, Lucy K Makeover. And you have Summer Miguel, SM class.
Yeah,
Summer Miguel class, yes. Yeah. And I'm really happy that you represent your brand.
Yeah.
But now, as Christians, you know, there's this concept that we're Christian. You should not look sharp. I don't know about you, but me, I'm always look sharp. Christians say you should not look sharp. You should not put on makeup. They condemn people saying that those who put on makeup and the dress looking classic and elegant are doomed for hell.
Yeah.
That, I mean, in fact, there's no other place where they'll go to. It's only hellfire. As I'm sitting here, I'm supposed to be hell. I'm destined for hell.
No.
It's not correct. Okay, so... what can you say about people who have this mentality?
Okay, it's a very bad mindset. Like, very, very bad. Because it's just like the gospel that we preach.
Mm-hmm.
It increases day by day. They have new patterns. Like, before, you don't have pastors on TV station, you know.
Yes.
So, some pastors are even owning their own studio. So, that's improvement.
Yeah.
So, it's just like beauty.
Mm-hmm.
Just from Tumankasa, like what they call it back then. Now you now have hair, you have braids, different kind of braids. We keep upgrading in beauty. It's the same way makeup is in vogue now.
Okay.
So it's an upgrade in beauty.
Yeah.
It has nothing to do with you going to hellfire or you going to heaven.
Less of a Christian.
Yes. It doesn't reduce your Christian standards.
Okay,
no.
Yeah,
so if you really want to look good, but do the things that you're supposed to do.
Do it right.
How is your heart as a Christian?
Mm-hmm.
Please, let's keep makeup aside.
Mm-hmm.
How is your heart?
Mm-hmm.
Like, you have problem with your neighbor and rain is falling. You don't go to take off the neighbor's dress.
Okay, that's bad.
It's bad, but you're a Christian.
Mm-hmm.
So you're forgetting about that. You're going to makeup.
Yeah.
So we should be working out our own salvation with fear and trembling. Not about makeup.
Fear and trembling.
Because you have to look good. If I'm to preach to some couple of people, don't want to listen to me because I look attractive.
That was it.
Yes.
Naturally, in the society, that's when you look attractive, you have more wins.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely.
Both in dating, in jobs, and in criminal trials. Because if you're looking tattered, they'll definitely know, this guy should be.
Yes, very, very.
But no one can see you like this summer and say you're a thief. I'm sure.
Okay, so what can you say as a man?
Okay.
You know, they say men should not put on slim trousers, all those, destroy all those things. I don't understand because it shocks me.
Actually, I don't know where that concept really comes from, you understand? Because normally, even the Bible says it, that's in the book of Revelation 21:21. The Bible says it clear that God, you understand, he actually painted the street with gold.
Mm-hmm.
Understand? And it glitters like glass.
Yeah. Yes.
So that means that shows that God is beauty.
Yes. Exactly.
You understand? It shows the beauty of God in mankind. Now, you carry God in you. Mm-hmm. That means God lives in you. So you need to actually represent who you actually have in you.
Exactly.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
And again, in the book of, I think that's Genesis 37 verse 3, it says, okay, let's forget about all the dreams Joseph actually had. Now, Joseph's father actually bought him a garment of many colors.
Yeah.
Now, when you try to reflect on that garment of many colors, and obviously, the brothers were actually envious of him, you understand?
Mm-hmm.
Now, meaning he actually looked good, the garment was attractive,
exactly.
Colorful, you understand?
Yeah.
That means us as Christians, that's what we need to portray.
Yeah. Yes.
You understand the point? So now with the concept of you not putting on this or not putting on that, destroy. Normally I put on destroy, but now what's inside of you?
Inside of you.
What's the mindset of it? It all lies down to decency. Okay. You understand? Now, okay, now see something. I'm a believer. Now, if I wanted to put on destroy, the way I'll put on my own destroy, it will not be the same as an unbeliever out there. Normally, not, they need to sag down their trousers right at the level of their thighs and stuff. But if I'm putting on my destroy right at the level of my waist, and now I also have my good shirt put on, and you understand, with a good jacket, and you understand, I look so responsible
look so
and
sharp.
Classy, looking
exactly.
So sharp, and I'm a sang Christian, so that's...
So, bottom line, what we are saying is it's possible to look classic and decent. We'll be back after the short break. Don't go nowhere. Welcome back, everybody. We are still talking about maintaining the balance between fashion and decency. So, Lucy K, can you tell me, you say it's okay to be fashionable and decent, but where do we draw the line?
Okay, like, as a Christian, just like the way I'm dressed, I know I'm looking so beautiful, but my private parts are not exposed.
Mm-hmm.
So you mustn't show off your breasts, your buttocks, no. Ash is a mess. So as a Christian, you look good, look beautiful, but don't expose your body.
Yeah, so there are limits.
I'm not talking about from year to year. You can expose, but not, you know what
I'm
saying.
Yeah, the intimate part of your body, yes, obviously.
It shouldn't be exposed.
Okay.
A no and a no, 1,000 times no.
Okay. Okay, so Sama Miguel, about boys, you know, we sometimes see in church, men coming to church with sack trousers and over-destroyed trousers. Where can we draw the line?
Now, the bottom line for that, you know, as a Christian, if you call yourself a Christian, you should know what your father needs in his house.
Yes.
You understand? And now, normally, as a Christian, when you're inside the house of God, you understand, normally, you shouldn't pretend while you're coming to church. You don't just put on something like, okay, now, I'm coming to church, I'm trying to put on this, now, when I'm out there, I try to do some other funny things. Now, okay, now, I'll say this. Or maybe for a Christian brother who comes to church and he's like, okay, no, that church like that, I need to like put on something which is so decent because I'm going to church today.
Yes.
And out of church, you dress indecent. You understand? Yes. That means you're not portraying, because God lives in you. Like, you understand? He lives in you. That means normally you portray him on daily basis everywhere you go. So inside the church, you portray God. Out of the church, you portray him. You understand? So normally, destroy in church. Actually, I don't have a problem with that. Or put on some stuff. I don't have a problem. My problem is that, how decent are you? How decent are you? Like, maybe put on, do you sag your trouser? Or maybe you have your chest exposed. You understand? For men, you have your chest exposed, showing your body build and stuff like that. Normally, you need to cover yourself. Like, the way I'm looking at that, I'm set for church. And even out of church,
yes.
I'm still set. No, yes. Some will admire me in church, and out of church, they'll still admire me. And you easily draw the line, and some will easily tell you this guy is a Christian or not.
Yes, that's it. So, just look good, Like, you know, I look so sharp. No one needs to tell me. I know that, baby. Okay, so we know you do makeup, and we know everything has its negativities. So, what are the after effects of heavy makeup?
Okay, makeup is good, but it has effect on its users, especially teens. You know, teenagers are already going through a lot of hormones, germs, and genes kind of issue. So adding makeup to it again is going to lead to infection.
Okay.
Yeah, to the body and to the face as well. So always remove your makeup.
Okay.
Like, we are well made up today. Mm-hmm. It's good to take a fresh bath in the night before you sleep.
Because we have some girls who sleep.
No,
it's
wrong. Even if you're so tired, like you are so tired, you just want to sleep, take off your makeup with wipes.
Okay.
Yes, have a facial wipes as a lady.
Okay.
Yes, take off your makeup.
So keep to the advice. Yeah.
Yes.
So is there any dressing tip you can give to our guys out there, colorblind, anything?
All right, for guys out there, in fact, it goes for guys and lady, you should know you. And then when you get a designer, your designer should know you. Mm-hmm. You understand? There are stuff that will look good on her, but not look good on you.
Yes.
You understand? Or maybe a dark person. So know your color. Mm-hmm. Like how you look like. Normally you're a light-skinned girl. Now, yes. Normally, so the colors I may design for you will not be the same color designed for a dark-skinned girl. You understand? Then know what fits you. Because it's fashion, it doesn't mean you just see anything which is fashionable from your own, it's on you and stuff like that. You
very
know,
true.
It looks so absurd, you understand? Mm-hmm. Know your body and know what fits you, then you go for the best. So about color blending now, I can't actually like tell you, no, this color is perfect with this or with this, because it all depends on you in person, like your skin tone and how I'll need to blend a particular design on you and a color.
Thank you very much. It was an awesome session. We were able to talk about so many things. We had tips on makeup, tips on dressing, and it was so awesome. And by the way, you can see, we all look so sharp. So bottom line, it's possible to be a Christian and to look elegant, beautiful as we all look today, and you're still different. So keep your integrity as a Christian, but still look sharp like a girl right here. It was a fun time with you guys. So before I leave you, I must mention this. We have Lucy K Fashion, who is coming up with who has an upcoming workshop. Can you tell us more about it?
Okay, we're having a workshop July / August section where we want to be training girls on how to do proper makeup, like professional,
okay,
then pedicure and manicure, how to be a good stylist.
Okay.
For just chickily money.
Chickily money. Okay, and for SM class, we have something big coming up. What's it about?
All right, I actually have a collection which is coming up, which is purely Africa. You understand? I want to portray, in fact, Africa, they say Africa in miniature. I want to portray our own Africa. You understand? It's high time our designers back here at home try to like limit a lot of Western and try to come back home with our.
Very accurate.
So, what I'll be doing next week, like the collections, you will have a lot to do with art. On my design and painting and color blend and stuff like that.
Okay, yeah. So I can't wait for this. By the way, SM class dressed me up and I am so
proud.
I look so beautiful. I know. Please give me some time. I look so nice. Thank you. You're welcome. Okay, now finally, I'll be leaving you guys. It was so much fun with you. See you next time. Bye.